Hello everybody and welcome to the T. Wilson channel. Today we're going to be going over why I think the DeLisle Carbine is the most interesting and possibly the best weapon in Sniper Elite. But first, a bit of history. The DeLisle Carbine is a silenced rifle designed during World War II by William DeLisle. When he approached the government with his design, they stood on the balcony of the New Adelphi building in London and fired live ammunition into the River Thames to see if people on the street below heard the weapon fire, and they didn't. It produces only 85.5 decibels when fired, compared to modern silenced handguns, which produce anywhere from 117 to 140 decibels when fired. And it's an incredibly rare gun, only about 130 were ever made. They're originally going to make 500, but they ended up just not being made. The requirement wasn't there. And to be completely honest, neither was the time or resources. A couple of the DeLisles had folding stocks, taken from the Sterling submachine gun for use by paratroopers, and it was used by commandos mostly, but the SOE also used them, and the SAS used them as well during the Troubles in Northern Ireland. And it's a bodge job of a gun, pretty much. It's got most of the internal workings from an Enfield. Uses the 45 automatic Colt pistol magazines from an M1911, and it is a parts bin, but does it work? Now, in terms of actual performance, the DeLisle Carbine has laughable damage, laughable range, poor fire rate, debatable accuracy, and to be honest, it really doesn't function well as a weapon. A weapon's objective is to kill a target or neutralize that target. It doesn't matter if it's an animal or a human or a robot or whatever. A weapon needs to kill. That's why they're there. And the DeLisle really isn't very good at this. And it is the best weapon in the game. And let me tell you why. It is permanently silenced. And that doesn't sound super useful. I mean, Sniper Elite isn't an ultra stealthy reliant game. It helps, but surely the ability to kill reliably with something like the Springfield or the Kakano is more useful than the ability to be quiet. Now, my recording doesn't really do it justice. Everything went a bit ball to the walls mental and I was spotted, and from then it was almost guaranteed chaos, as I was in the heart of the final level. But I still think you can get the idea of what the DeLisle's meant for. Having the silenced ability is so useful. I played through Deathstorm 3 recently, and it was quite frankly amazing with the DeLisle. I got, I think it was 140-ish kills, and I think 110 were stealth kills, and I was completely stealthy up until that final bit after you destroy the reactors or whatever and have to escape the area. And I just have to say, it was amazing. The ability to not be seen for an entire level, to not be heard, to not be found, is just perfect, and you couple that with like the well rod or the HDM, and you're just set. There's absolutely no reason you'd ever like encounter a part where you need to use a submachine gun, unless you mess up really badly, like what I did in this recording, and let everybody in the fortress see you. I feel like I'm repeating myself a bit, so I urge you, just go out, use the DeLisle. If you don't have the DeLisle, buy the DLC for it. It's probably dead cheap, I don't know. And quite frankly, Rebellion are worth the money. They don't get nearly enough credit as they should do. And I'm going to talk about that in the Sniper Elite review that I am probably going to do. But I genuinely think that it is the best weapon in the game, just because of that silenced ability. So go out, get the DLC if you haven't already, and play through the story with just the DeLisle and the well rod or the HDM or whatever, and just try and be silent for the whole thing. And I guarantee you, you'll have a lot of fun doing it.